We have two public comment speakers signed up this evening. Our first speaker is David Richard.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Let's run through the thing here. My name is David Richard. I'm speaking for myself. I do not represent any organization other than myself, and I don't have a personal interest in any particular pending matter except as a taxpayer. First of all, I want to thank the members of this commission for doing something the previous commission wouldn't do. Clear former registrar of voters Gary Smith's name. That you had to act at all on this issue is the reason I'm speaking to you this evening. This arm of government aided and abetted the destruction of a citizen's reputation solely on the basis of a politically motivated witch hunt while caring more for their own public perception. That 5-0 failure of leadership was a result of listening too much to political activists. There's a few people behind me that are concerned citizens whose only concern is about what you might do that will directly affect the lives of others or their property. You need to listen to them. Political activists, nothing but look at me. My suggestion, don't waste your time on political activists. They want your attention. They need your attention. They crave your attention. I don't know whether they were bottle babies growing up as infants or whether they were always the last person picked at dodgeball. But when you give them your time, you're elevating them to something above the annoyance they merely are. Don't elevate them. If they're saying something of importance to this county or your performance, listen to them. If they're not, as is likely, look concerned and hum your favorite tune in your head. Go over the shopping list your wife gave you to pick up on the way home. If you really want to tick them off, pull out your PDA and start tapping on the keyboard. If they ask you what you're doing, tell them you're texting another commissioner about what a waste of oxygen they truly are. But always remember that your job is to do the work of Forsyth County. You say you're getting harassing emails from these political activists? There's a special button on your keyboard to deal with the Milams, Meadows, and Tisdales of the world. It's called the delete key, and it works just fine. But don't you or your appointees get into a war of words with these people because they are living, mouth-breathing proof you can't argue with certain people. After thousands of staff productivity hours, hundreds of thousands of taxpayer dollars wasted in meaningless pursuits over the years, all these people have to show for their efforts are that their names are recognizable to someone outside of their own immediate family. Don't add to their self-importance by giving them the time of day, because you're just giving them the attention they crave and wasting our tax dollars in your efforts. Focus on the really important issues this board has to address. Animal control, budgets, a growing water problem, and an ever-present and always important issue of public safety. Look, if you're doing something wrong, it's not the political activists who'll be here up at this podium. Oh, no. You'll know when you're doing something really wrong when I come to speak to you.
Thank you.
Our next speaker is Nydia Tisdale.
Hello, Commissioners. My name is Nydia Tisdale. I am a citizen of the United States of America. I am a resident of the state of Georgia, county of Fulton, and city of Roswell. I am a homeowner in Brookfield Country Club. I am a dues-paying member of Smart Growth Forsyth County, which meets on the third Tuesday of every month, and I invite you all to join our meetings at the Forsyth County Cumming Chamber of Commerce Events Facility on Kelly Mill Road. I am a blogger for About Forsyth online forum, which was featured in the Atlanta Journal-Constitution on Monday, February 14th, 2011. I speak for myself. No one is paying me. The Georgia Sunshine Laws refer to two laws governing open records and open and public meetings. And I will leave you all with a copy of A Citizen's Guide to Open Government. At the February Forsyth County Civil Service Board meeting held at the Public Safety Complex, the chairman stated, "We do not ask our clerk every time if she publishes in the administration building publicly because she always does it." The clerk replied, "I do post it in the bookcase at the county administration building, that being the main building of the county. just as a courtesy for the people that are coming in this day, because we know sometimes we may be in the conference room, sometimes we may be in the classroom, that we'll publish it on the front door here. But it's always been published in the administration building. According to Georgia records, Open Meetings and Public Meetings Act, due notice shall be the posting of a written notice for at least 24 hours at the place of regular meetings. The Civil Service Board meets in the public safety complex, not in the administration building. Due notice was not posted in the proper place. Any official action of any agency adopted or made at a meeting which is not open to the public as required shall not be binding. The Attorney General shall have authority to bring enforcement actions, either civil or criminal, in his discretion as may be appropriate to enforce compliance. To quote Attorney General Sam Olens, from my perspective, transparency and accountability are great things.
Thank you.
That was our final speaker, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you.